Hello everyone. So it's a new day. It's a new set of GMAT percentiles. And in this video, I'm going to really walk you through the new GMAT percentiles that just dropped yesterday. I'm going to talk about what has changed, who does it impact and who does it not impact, and how should you deal with it. So without much further ado, let's get on with it. So first of all, so let's start with what has changed. The two big changes are that 695 right now is 97th percentile, which means it's the new 740. Remember, 695 used to be 98th percentile or equivalent to the old 750 score. Now it's 97th or the new 740. Similarly, 635 right now is the new 80th percentile in the prior scoring system. 625 was the 80th percentile. And for those of you who've been with me for some time, you'd remember when the Focus Edition started, 615 was the 80th percentile. So there's definitely been more people scoring slightly higher. We've had 2 years of GMAT percentile scores. And so right now we're at that point where you know, the 80th percentile is kind of settling into that 615, 635 era. Now, there are certain things which haven't changed. Your 99th percentile is still 715, so that's wonderful. Your 100th percentile is still 735. It hasn't changed since the inception of the Focus Edition. And your 98th percentile, that hasn't changed as well. It's 655. Now, it did change from last year from a 645 to a 655, but this year it's been robust and it's phenomenal. So that, I think, is the good news. Now, you guys can really see where these percentiles are. This is on gmat.com, and you can see the changes here. Let me see if I can zoom it in a bit. Yes. So again, you can really see that 695 now is a 97th percentile. It used to be a 98th percentile. So it should be used to be at par with 705. Similarly, that 635 is where the 80th percentile line crosses. 625 now is a 79th percentile. If you want to really see the older percentiles, you can go to our article. We'll soon be updating it. But this gives you a really good reference with regards to this. So what caused this change? I think the first piece that I want to really talk about is that what hasn't changed. And this is huge. Why? Because in the past, whenever GMAT percentiles fluctuated, I'm talking about the classical GMAT and also to a certain extent, the past change in the Focus Edition was primarily driven by changes in quant. But this year, there hasn't been any change in quant. In fact, when I say hasn't been any major, there hasn't been any as far as what I can see. So in other words, you know, the GMAT seems to have a really good handle on how to work with quant percentiles. Your 80th percentile is still 83 or a Q83. Your 90th percentile point is still a Q86. And a 70th percentile point is still a Q81 here. And you can really see if you go back to our platform over here and you expand the score table, that 86 is still that 91st percentile, that 80th percentile is still 83, and then you're crossing the 70th percentile at 81. So this hasn't changed when you look at the new quant percentiles as well. These numbers are pretty much the same over here. Okay, so what has changed? Let's go back here and So now let's talk about what has changed here. The biggest change that has happened is on the verbal percentile. So I want to explain this concept of what I call as tug. We now have essentially a one percentile tug starting at V77. In the older version of the GMAT, a V77 used to be a 31st percentile. Let me just shade this over here. This is what it used to be. And now, let's just change the color here. This is what it is. So at that V77 level, there are more people who are getting to that V77 level. So that's something which is absolutely clear. Okay, let's make sure we do this over here. Okay, similarly, at that V82, and this is where the next major tug comes in, that's now a 74th percentile versus a 76th. So you now have one additional point of tug that comes in, which means more people are getting to a V82 over here. Now, that gain is fairly short-lived. At V83, we kind of lose one percentile point, so there's a minus one over here, as you can really see in this case, which is now an 83rd percentile versus an 84. But then beyond that, you know, those changes actually go give up. So it seems like there's this swell in the middle section where more people are scoring V77 to V84-ish. And then from that point on, outside of these two ranges over here. So if I were to draw some sort of a chart, let me just see if I can zoom it in here. So if I were to draw some sort of a chart over here, in this case, essentially. So you have, and this is where you have, you know, V60 to V90. So you have more people in that V77 to V84 mark. So that bracket, the number of people has expanded, but beyond this over here, this and this hasn't expanded. A few people from here have come in here, but then the number of people who are at V84 or higher, which was at 90th percentile or higher, that hasn't changed a whole lot. 90th percentile is now technically an 85. It used to be 84, but then you have that one percentile point. And let me show this to you over here. So I'm gonna go into verbal scoring, and you can really see V84 used to be 90th percentile, now it's 89. So technically V85 is a 90th percentile point, but again, it goes all the way to 94. V86 is still a 96, V87 is still a 98, and then you still have V88 as 99th here. So this hasn't changed. If you go back to our percentile chart here, you can really see the same thing. 86 is 97, 85 is 94, but 84 used to be 90. So that's something which is there, and you can really see these points here as well. So that's kind of the biggest change, in my opinion, that has happened. DI percentiles, not a whole lot of changed here. So there's a one percentile tag at a DI 71 that used to be a 26th percentile. So this is what was the old one here. Now it is a 25th percentile. So that's the old thing. And that's that tug is essentially continues all the way to essentially around that 90th percentile overall. So that there's this one percentile piece that comes in that DI 71, and that pushes all of those percentiles by 1 point. So in other words, if I were to translate this here, so if I go into that DI 71, you can really see this is 25 versus 26, 72 is 29. Earlier it used to be 30 here. Now DI 80 used to be 84, now it's 83 all the way. But then you give up those gains as you get to those higher percentiles. Again, the story is very, very similar. As you go to the higher percentiles, nothing has changed, but only at those lower percentiles, or that, I won't call it lower, but at that, at those percentiles where scores were not super high, but really high enough, around that 80th percentile is where the biggest difference is. But when you get to that 90th percentile, you know, those changes are gone again. So your 99th percentile is still 86. These are not, they haven't changed. 98th percentile is still 85 in DI. Again, you can really see the other ones. 98th percentile is still in that 81, 82 mark. So all of this is good news. If you were scoring high, then you know, you're good. Now, what does this mean? So I have two segments of folks here, and I'm gonna just zoom it in over here and bring this front and center. So if you're someone who's taken the test already, you're done with it and you're preparing your application. So if you have a score of 715 or higher, be really, really happy. Nothing's changed for you. That's still the 99th percentile. 735 is still 100th percentile. You have no additional competition. If you have a 705, I think you are in some ways better off, because earlier both 705 and 695 were 98th percentiles. Now it's just 705. So be happy over here. So be this guy in this case. However, if you were someone who was at a 695, you know, you, in my opinion, it's that segment that's kind of lost a bit, because now you're a 97th percentile versus a 98th percentile. That's truly recommend that you strengthen your application. That's one piece. You know, if you don't want to take the GMAT again, or if you want to take the GMAT again, still apply in round one if you have a score, but then think about improving your GMAT score once your application is done. Again, only if scholarships are important to you, because now suddenly it can happen that the outcome views your application slightly differently. Because remember, 695 used to be the old 750, now it's the old 740. So again, if they still have that memory of what a 740 applicant was versus the 750, that could have an impact on your score. But again, if you strengthen your application, you think you're good enough, again, you don't have to do anything. If you are in that 645 to 685, nothing's changed for you. Those percentiles still remain the same, so stay happy. If, on the other hand, you have the 605 to 635, again, if you're applying to a T1, I'd recommend scoring higher anyway. If you're applying to a Tier 1 school, now you have even more motivation. Again, if you're still preparing, let's kind of go to the right-hand side. And if you're still preparing, 715, no change. The biggest change is for those who were aiming for a 695. I'd recommend that you aim for a 705. Just, it's incremental effort, and maybe focus on improving verbal, or if it makes sense, depending on what your strengths are, improve, your quant or your DI by a single point here. So that's something that I'd really just say. But for everyone else, unless and if you are in this bracket over here, I'd again recommend, if you're aiming for that 80th percentile, aim for those 10 points more. Again, is that a huge change? Not really, but it's really important to have that mindset change here. So what does this mean overall? So one takeaway that I want you to have is that there is no major change in percentiles. Those percentile tables have stood the test of time for 2 years now, or close to about 300,000 or more data points, and so the scoring system is extremely robust. So that's really important here. The second thing which is there is that, and I think this is my biggest takeaway, your quant and DI are more or less constant. Actually, I should just use a slightly different color now. Yeah, your quant and DI are more or less constant. So these are usually the sections where I'd expect most changes, but they've been robust. Again, shows how good a job the GMAC has done here. Verbal percentiles have changed. They've changed slightly, not a whole lot. So are they expected to change more next year? I don't expect them to change a whole lot. This is, I think, a very minor fine-tuning that has happened, and you can really see the score ranges where you have those one percentile tugs. I think that this is gonna, in my opinion, this is gonna stay like this for some time on the verbal side. Quant or DI is what I anticipated that will change slightly in the next year, if at all. But overall, I expect the entire scoring system to stay more or less consistent, unless we see a significant change in the test-taking population. The big change, honestly, for me is for these guys. The 695, that's kind of settled more into the 97th percentile right now, and also that 625 right now is no longer that 80th percentile. Those are two big changes. Again, these are more mindset. I mean, the overall change, the delta is one percentile point. So in the context of everything, it's not huge. But again, it's a mindset change, how that number looks on your score report. But overall, I want to congratulate the GMAC for delivering very, very reliable score estimates. These scores, this brand new scoring system, has, in my opinion, stood the test of time, and is going to continue to be performed just as robustly as it has done over the last 2 years. With that, as we always say, happy learning.